Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 14 of the Settlements and Survival series. Today, we are going to start making our way down to Jamaica Plain because I love doing Jamaica Plain at low levels. I've never done it at this low level before. Right now, she's only 14, and Jamaica Plain is like a 30 to 45 zone, so 30 to 40 zone. So first things first, we're going to clear these dogs out of this junkyard because we need to go through here, and having the meat is going to be handy when we get down to Jamaica Plain because there's a cooking station in the church that I can use for extra food, so I don't have to carry a lot of food with me. So we piss them off, let the turrets and the guard do the work because I'm going to ask. And oh, legendary, hello. That probably should have used bats on him. But look at that. My second favorite legendary, strength and endurance. Favorite, of course, is agility, perception, cunning. Cunning and then fortifying, so whatever. Anyway, here's the guard doing his thing. He's got all their attention. Good. I'll help him out. I think he can die. I think they can kill him, but they're not going to hear. So yeah, we're going to kill these guys. And in this episode, since Jamaica Plain is, I took a lot longer to clear it than I thought I did. So this first installment of our multi-part sub-series is going to be going down to Jamaica Plain and establishing our beachhead, getting a perimeter done. In preparation for this, I brought 200 rounds for the pistol and 100 rounds for the rifle because I don't know how much ammo I'm going to need, but I'm going to need a lot. And carrying capacity is not an issue because I'm not going to loot till it's clear anyways for the most part. And Jamaica Plain is full of stuff, so no big deal. So here's the Red Rocket. When you come out, you go south from Diamond City. Now, you could go one street over. If you cut through the junkyard where the dogs were and go straight through, you'll come out on the street to the right over there and you can just go straight down the road. But for now, I wanted to go by here because I got that legendary. So I'm gonna grab all this crap here. I'm gonna use that armor workbench and upgrade this thing if I can. So we're gonna upgrade it. We got a muffled something or other. I put a couple of buffs on it. So now I've got an extra 5 carry capacity. Now I lose 3 armor, but that's okay. That's a trade-off I'm willing to make for the carrying capacity at this stage. I'll worry about upgrading it later because I can upgrade it better with, better steps. Let's put it on. There's our burden to 205. Very nice. We lost, like I said, 3 armor, but where we're going, 3 armor ain't going to be a make or break situation. So now here's how close Jamaica Plain is to Diamond City. If you've never actually run this, if you always just, come down by South Boston Checkpoint, you may not have realized just how close this is. Now on the right there, you can see over the hill, not straight ahead, but over on the right is Fairline Estates. That's where the ghouls are and the Yagwai, and Eleanor's in her trailer over there. So if you like automatic weapons, if you like assault rifles, Eleanor is going to be your favorite person. She sells tons of 5.56 ammo. Right there is Milton General Hospital. And another dog just died, looks like. So there's the hospital. Fallon's is back on the right. Shaw's across the street. The Super Mutants are in that plaza. That weird parking garage is over there. But this is where we are. I mean, we literally, 2 minutes, right? And we're down here. So now I'm going to stay away from Shaw. I'm just going to go down here, and I'm going to check to see if there's anything in that intersection because that's a spawn point by that trailer. Nobody down the street there. Nobody down here. Sweet. Now I'm thinking that Raider camp, has a bed in it. It turns out it does not. But watch. Shot it right in the chest and nothing. I'm like, okay, this is not good because of course we're in a higher level zone and I'm only level 14. So leveled enemies are going to be very, very difficult. I have to be really careful doing this. But I want to kill those two raiders. I got to kill them because I'm pretty sure there's a bed in there. So we're going to get this guy in the head. So now at this point, I've tagged both of them. And shoot him again, and he doesn't die. And I'm like, oh, this is a problem. You know what? I'm gonna train him into the ghouls. Let's see if I can get the ghouls to aggro him. Let's see if they'll follow me in here and piss off the ghouls while I sneak in. Now, a tactical note. If enemies are chasing you and the caution's up there, you won't know when new enemies aggro you because you won't go to caution. You'll already be in caution. I learned that lesson the hard way right about here. Yeah. Third of my health, one shot, arms crippled. It's time to go. Yeah, no ghouls. Goodbye. Goodbye. Here's my friend the raider. This is not good. 1 and how many shots? 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 and 7. He's not dead. And did you see that dog? I didn't. So we're just going to run. It's like the ghouls are chasing me. The raiders are chasing me. The raider just died. 78. The ghouls killed him. I thought the ghouls killed him. Turns out the dogs killed him. The dogs that I have not yet seen. So, there's a settler. The settler always wants water. Sorry, it's survival. You are on your own. I don't have it to spare right now. So now let's go back. Let's go see what happened down there. Let's see if we did loot that raider. He's probably got... Hello, legendary skull mongrel. Yeah, no, puppy. We're not doing that. But I'm thinking, ooh, a legendary. If I can kill him, I can cheese him, maybe I can kill him. So let's get a place where he can't get to and see if I can't just snipe him, you know, like wear him down. Because if I can wear him down, I can kill him. You know, I've got enough ammo for that. I'm thinking, yeah, let's give that a shot. So we get on the edge of this wall and we look. And look at that, 14% on the torso from this distance, that's not going to be good. So let's go down and see if we can't pick off one of the stranglers. Because usually the dogs come in threes, the legendary and two more. There's the legendary. See how he's wounded? The raider shot him. So I know now the dog killed him. But look at him running around. And they see me up on top of the car, and I'm like, nope, time to go. So now we go take another shot at this. See if I can't, because they're in my way. I have to go through this way, or at least I think I do at this point. Back up on the wall. Kind of ease down. Watch that hidden thing flicker. Because again, they are high level, I'm low level, so they can detect me a lot better than other enemies, than same level enemies. Even with sneak three, they're still going to see me. So look at them, running. I haven't yet figured out that they are not going to stop. They are running back and forth between the intersection and the end of that truck, and they're just going back and forth. They're not going to stop. I can't VATS them from here. If I do, they're just going to run away because they know they can't get to me, right? They'll run up to me and then run away when they figure out they can't get to me. So I'm like, you know what? I ain't got time for this. I need to get you to make a plane. I need to sleep. We need to get, you know, make my progress good. So let's just avoid these guys. Let's just go down and pass down the back of Shaw here. I'm being careful because I don't know if that second raider is dead. I know one of them's dead for sure, but I'm not sure if the second one is. And that second one's going to be a handful if they catch me in the open. Plus, if I start shooting, the dogs are going to come see what's going on. And this, so I'm looking, I'm like, yeah, maybe. But look at them running. Yeah, that's not going to be good. Plus, this low wall is not going to be good protection. So I'm looking for the sleeping bag, looking for the raider. Looking. Nope. Okay, let's just keep going. Now, here's the biggest chance I took in this thing. Because down here by this bus, you get stingwing spawning out here sometimes. And if a stingwing aggro's me, I'm going to die. They will just murder me dead. Because they are so tough for me at this level. Even with the VATS, even with the heavy guns, they could wreck me pretty bad. So we're just going to avoid. We're going to watch that hidden thing. Check Hyde Park. Make sure no raiders are coming. Okay, there's the turret. We're going to hide behind the trees here. We're going to shoot and then move to the left. So in case it does shoot, it's going to hit those trees instead of me. And boom. Okay. Now we go look for the sleeping bag that I think is here. But that is, unfortunately, not. On the bright side, there is stuff here. There's a duffel bag. Usually dead raiders, dead settlers. Yeah, look at no sleeping bag, dude. Sorry. Grab that stim pack. Leave that Nuka-Cola. We'll grab that ammo. Let's grab the duffel bag. You got some money. Hey, how you doing? Pulse grenade. Won't come in handy against ghouls, but hey, it sells. So let's take it. Okay, so now we need to go to town. Now, I know there's another bed on the edge, on the outskirts of Jamaica Plain, but there are also a ton of mines. Thankfully, I have Sneak 3, so I'm not going to trip them. What I'm most concerned about at this point is accidentally aggroing a ghoul and having the ghoul trip the mine, because Sneak 3 doesn't protect you against blast damage. It only means you don't trigger the mine. And I'm going to need these mines for my eventual clearing of the south end of town. And I'll explain why on that one in the next video when we get to that point. But right now, my biggest goal here, my only goal here, is to clear the area, establish a perimeter, establish a beachhead, get rid of the biggest hazards, find a place to sleep that I can sleep at. Because right now, that house right there has a mattress on the top floor. And it is a really good spot for a number of reasons, one of which you'll see in a moment when I start pissing these guys off. But right now, I just want to sleep. I want to save my progress. And here it is. Boop. And save. So now I'm good. Right? I'm good. I've got no sicknesses. I got no illnesses. Now let's start clearing the vicinity here. Let's go ahead and start taking out everybody near this house, so that even if I aggro them later, I'll still have a place to hide, place to sleep. So now he's aggro. Now he's downstairs, right? For whatever reason, they can't path up those stairs. I don't know why. Maybe it's the architecture, whatever. But see, he's running away. He doesn't think he can get to me. So now I wait for him to calm down. It takes about 30 seconds because he runs around. And here he comes back again. But I'm hidden. So let's just go ahead and pop his ass over the top of this wall. Hey, dude, smile. Double tap and down. So now the hidden bars, I'm watching the hidden bars. They're sort of moving, but not too much. So there's stuff close, but not terribly close. Let's start clearing that red house just a little bit. That red house is dangerous for like a ton of reasons. One of which, the bottom floor blows up. Two, the ghouls can freely path through that house. They don't have any problem getting up and down those stairs. And three, at this level, there's usually, in Jamaica Plain, there's usually at least two, sometimes as many as five legendaries. Okay, I have to treat every cluster of ghouls as a potential legendary encounter. And again, at this level with this armament, I'm going to have a really tough time killing them. They will murder me. So I got to be careful. So let's pop that dude in the main house. Get up here where we can see him. He's sitting in a sleeping bag and boop. And look at that. Didn't even turn red. So if anybody's near him, they're sleeping. Nobody's going to come after me right now. Let's go check the house. Now, at this stage of this journey, I had forgotten what it takes to clear Jamaica Plain. So I go back to the workbench a lot to check it to see if I can unlock it yet. Because if I can unlock it, hey man, I can place a real bed and game over. So I go up the stairs. We're going to go loot this guy. See what we got going on here. Grab some stuff. And here he is. Oh, downstairs. Forgot about you. Well, go back to sleep. Thanks, man. Grab his stuff. Check. Okay. I don't sleep there, but I check if I can. Because if I can sleep there, I know there's no enemies nearby. Or at least none close enough to prevent me from sleeping. Grab what I need, get out the door, keep an eye out for anybody spawning in the town square there. Because I don't know, check the workshop, can't open it, grab this frag grenade, frag mine. So now I've got bottle cap mines and frag mines, and I'm doing pretty good. And we have pretty much cleared everything around this house. So we're doing pretty good, I think, so far. So far, so good. We're going to grab the loot from this guy here. We're not getting anywhere near that house yet. And we're going to go to sleep. I want to thank you all very much for subscribing and watching, and I will see you in the next one. Take care.